Mankind is the upright ape, evolved perfectly for walking and running on land. But we also have some evolutionary features that allow us to enjoy a dip in the ocean. And as we've advanced as a species, we've invented complex technology to take us deep into the oceans. But take away all this, and how far can we go without a big submersible to protect us? What's the lowest depth humans can survive?
I'm Stu, this is Debunked, where we talk the truths from the myths and the facts from the misconceptions.
But before we dive into this, we'd like to introduce you to Magellan TV, who have made this video possible. Magellan TV is a premium documentary streaming service hosting thousands of hours of docuseries and feature films, covering everything from history, culture, and true crime to space, nature, and mind and body, with the largest collection of science content anywhere. That you can watch on practically any device. Plus, with new programs added every week, why not take advantage of our free trial and gain some extra knowledge with some incredible eye-opening factual entertainment? Just visit try.magellantv.com/debunked or click on the link in the description and snap yourself up some free entertainment. Deepsea diving has many dangers, and I don't just mean sharks and harpoon-wielding Bond villains. The effects of water pressure are the biggest challenge to the human body. Sitting on your boat at sea level, the air pressure is one atmosphere, to which your body is comfortably adapted. But just 33 feet, 10 meters underwater, the pressure is two atmospheres. With only this one additional atmosphere of pressure, your lungs will collapse by half. And the pressure increases by one atmosphere for every additional 33 feet, 10 meters, you dive. This increased pressure can lead to several problems in the human body, which is not well adapted to underwater conditions, regardless of the gear you're wearing. You might suffer barotrauma, as the water pressure squeezes the air pockets inside you and ruptures your eardrums, or bursts the air sacs in your lungs. If air bubbles get into your blood, you might suffer an embolism, causing a heart attack or stroke. Bad enough on land, even worse when you're 100 feet underwater. Alternatively, you might experience the rapture of the deep, or less poetically, nitrogen narcosis. This happens because higher pressures allow your body to absorb more nitrogen, which makes up 78% of the air we breathe. If you breathe too much nitrogen, you'll feel a little drunk. At 328 feet, around 100 meters deep, you could pass out. At shallower depths, you might do stupid things like try to breathe without your regulator, or rise to the surface too quickly, which can lead to decompression sickness, also known as the bends. Rising at the right rate allows your lungs to expel all that extra nitrogen your body absorbs at higher pressure. If you rise too fast, the gases will expand suddenly, like opening a fizzy drink. These bubbles can cause joint pains, nerve damage, paralysis, or if the bubble gets into your brain, death. To mitigate these dangers, scuba divers must be properly trained, and scuba tanks often contain a special mix of compressed air that is up to 36% oxygen. And just to be sure, the recommended safe limit for diving is no more than 130 feet or 39 meters deep. Scuba gear and carefully diving can help you avoid these nasty conditions. But what if you don't have any gear? How deep can you dive just holding your breath? Diving this way is called freediving, and humans can do pretty well without an oxygen tank, thanks to a perk of evolution called the mammalian diving reflex. This is triggered by holding your breath and wetting receptors in your nostrils. Basically, when you submerge your face in cold water, your body goes into diving mode. This reflex triggers several physiological changes. The first, bradycardia, reduces the rate at which your body consumes oxygen, by slowing your heart rate by 10 to 25%. Some professional freedivers can slow their hearts to only 14 beats per minute. That's three times slower than a person in a coma. The mammalian diving reflex also lowers your blood pressure, which allows for peripheral vasoconstriction, the constriction of blood vessels in your limbs. This moves oxygenated blood towards the important organs like the heart, the brain, and in particular, blood shifts to the lungs to expand the vessels and balance out the pressure from the water. Despite our mammalian diving reflex superpower, freediving is one of the most dangerous sports on Earth, with a long list of fatalities to back this up. And no limits freediving is widely considered the most dangerous form of freediving. This sees you strapped to a weighted diving sled attached to a rope. before you're plummeted to record-breaking depths within a couple of minutes. In 1949, scientists claimed that it would be impossible to dive deeper than 100 to 130 feet, or 30 to 40 meters deep, without your lungs fatally collapsing. During the 19th century, this is the depth pearl hunters would dive on a single breath to gather oysters and mussels to extract pearls. But in 2007, Herbert Nietzsche smashed through this limit sevenfold by plunging all the way down to over 700 feet or 214 meters. This is deeper than some World War II U-boats could go before they collapsed. The water would press down with a force of around 308 pounds per square inch, compressing your lungs to the size of tennis balls. In 2012, Herbert Nietzsche improved his record to 831 feet, or 253 meters. But afterwards, he suffered serious decompression sickness. He went through months of rehabilitation and several brain strokes before recovering. Incredibly though, this may not be the limit. Author and journalist James Nestor and biophysician John Fitzclark believe that Nietzsche's record is still a way off the maximum depth. Clark's laboratory simulations suggest that the ultimate limit is actually close to 1,000 feet or 300 meters deep. That's more than three American football fields end to end, and the equivalent to climbing to the top of the Eiffel Tower underwater. Even if you throw your scuba gear back on, it'll be tough to beat this predicted 1,000 feet limit, with the deepest ever recorded scuba dive coming in at 1,090 feet or 332 meters by Ahmed Gabur in the Red Sea in 2014. To help him reach this depth, he breathed a mixture of nitrogen, oxygen, and helium to avoid the problems of nitrogen narcosis. However, breathing helium at high pressures has its own risks, including high-pressure neurological syndrome, which can cause nausea, sleeplessness, and involuntary muscle jerks. Not wanting to lose control of his limbs, Ahmed returned to the surface when symptoms of this syndrome started to show. The dive itself took just 12 minutes, but the dangers of decompression meant it took him 15 hours to safely return to the surface. The sheer length of time it takes to decompress is a problem for commercial divers, who need to spend hours working at great depths. In order to get around this, they use a technique called saturation diving. Often used by gas and oil industries, this is where the diver adjusts their body to deep water pressures in a high-pressure chamber, and uses it or a pressurized diving bell to travel to and from the ocean floor. With divers never actually leaving the pressurized environment, they don't need to spend days decompressing each time they need to return to the surface. They just return in the pod and continue living under the same pressure of the deep sea. And with decompression from saturation diving taking more than a day per 100 foot or 30 meters, you'd otherwise be looking at a lot of lost work hours. As such, saturation divers will live in a pressure chamber for up to 28 days at a time. That's a long time to risk sickness from breathing nitrogen at high pressure. So saturation divers breathe a mix of oxygen and helium.
Not only does the helium help you pass the time with funny voices,
but it also comes in useful as it's rather good at conducting heat. And that's pretty important, with the cold depths of the ocean hitting an average temperature of 3.8 degrees Celsius, or 39 degrees Fahrenheit. But that's not enough to prevent them from suffering hypothermia. So saturation divers also usually have warm water pumped into the outer layer of their suits, via an umbilical connected to the surface, keeping them nice and toasty at the bottom of the ocean. Divers can then simply swim around at depths that would otherwise crush them into oblivion. In fact, in 1988, the deepest dive ever recorded saw a team of French commercial divers spend 6 days working at a depth of over 1,700 feet, or 534 meters, about 1.3 times the height of the Empire State Building, and deeper than the maximum diving depth of a blue whale. The water pressure was so high that their lungs were almost at zero capacity and could barely function. So they breathed a special mixture, mostly comprised of the lightest gas known to man, hydrogen, and contained just 1% of that annoyingly heavy gas, oxygen. Whilst this is the deepest actual open water dive ever recorded, Comex followed this up in 1992 with an experiment in a hyperbaric research chamber, which proved humans can survive even deeper still, with one diver reaching a synthesized depth of 2,300 feet, or 701 meters. This record-breaking experiment required 24 days of decompression and a further 2.5 months of monitoring. If you'd like to know more about the limits of human survival, then let us know in the comments. But in the meantime, would you like to learn about the critical development stage that the teenage brain goes through, and how it is key to the survival of the human species?
Adolescence is so important because it is the evolutionary adaptational component which leads to our species surviving.
Then we'd highly recommend watching Surviving the Teenage Brain, a great documentary where you'll discover all of this from a scientific and evolutionary point of view. Watch this and tons of other brain-boggling documentaries for free by clicking on the link in the description or visiting try.magellantv.com/debunked. Support from Magellan TV helps us keep making more of the content you love. So please head on over and grab yourself a free pass to some mind-expanding entertainment. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.